बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम सादिया इकबाल ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ गैरेजन एकेडमी सीनियर कैंपस। वेलकम यू ऑल टू एपसेक्स ऑनलाइन सपोर्ट प्रोग्राम। एज यू ऑल नो दैट दिस इज़ आवर सिक्स्थ वीक, लास्ट डे फ्राइडे एंड लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ द टॉपिक डिफ्रेंसिएशन बाई डेफिनेशन और बाई एबिनिशियो मैथड और बाई फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल। सो वाई एम आई सीइंग लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस, बिकॉज टुडे वी आर गोना डू इंशाल्लाह एक्सरसाइज 2.2 इन विच द सेम टॉपिक इज गोइंग ऑन, राइट। And from 2.3, inshallah, we will be having differentiation, of course. Derivative hi hum find karenge, but that would be a different process, right? It would not be by first principle or by ab initio method or by definition. So, at the end of today's lecture, inshallah, you will be able to understand the concept of differentiation and derivation by the first principle, ab initio method, and by definition. And today's topic is almost the same as our previous lectures of differentiation. There would be a slight difference of a very slight change of the independent variable, right? And then inshallah we will be doing question number 1, which is having 5 parts. So this exercise basically is having only 5 parts, 5 questions, right? And then we will be discussing a few questions from them, from those 5 parts, and I'll be giving rest for the assignment. So let us get started. Okay, now this is the exercise 2.2. The question is, find from first principles the derivatives of the following expression with respect to their respective independent variable. Ab kyun keh rahe hain their respective independent variable? Kyunki what did we do in the previous exercise, if you remember, in 2.2? All the independent variables were x. You know, all the questions had same independent variable, which was x. But here, look at this. Okay, here you can see that ax plus b is a constant, a is a constant, but x, this is a variable. So here independent variable is x. We will be taking y is equal to this, and rest of the process will be exactly same, right? Look at this one again. Independent variable is x, right? Look at this one, this is different. Here independent variable is t, not x, nothing else but t. So again we will be taking it as y equals to this thing. And what are we going to do? What is the difference between this question and the second or first? What is the difference between these questions? Look at this again. What is the difference between this or this? I mean, you know, despite of the values that this has 3 or 2 or the power and all, despite of those things, what else is the difference? It has a variable x, it has a variable t, and definitely these functions are independent, right? This has the variable which these values have, these functions have, is independent, right? So what is the difference? It has x, it has t. So for this question we will be finding change in y with respect to this x, delta y over delta x. But for this question we will be finding change in y, yani delta y, divided by change in t. Getting it? Okay, so the function, the thing will become basically dy over dt for this question, and for this question it would again be dy over dx. Okay, now look at the rest one. Once, okay, look at this one, it has again x, so we will be finding dy over dx. Okay, look at this one, 1 divided by az minus b whole raised to the power 7, b being constant, a being constant, but z being the variable, right? So what do we have to find? We will be finding here dy, yani change in y, divided by dz, change in y with respect to change in z, because z is the variable which is used here as independent variable. Clear? Let us discuss this thing in detail over here. Yahi thoda sa, this is the slight difference from the previous exercise. Baki everything is almost the same. Okay, this is the binomial series. We discussed this in very detail in the previous lecture. If you remember, 1 plus x whole raised to the power n, 1 equals to 1 plus nx plus n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial into x square. Okay, now look at this one thing which I have to remind you of, that here you should have 1 always. Okay, the power could be anything, and rest of the things which would be here would be considered as your x. And if the term has a minus sign with it, you have to convert it into the plus, and that minus would go with x, right? We discussed this thing in very detail. Okay, now step 1 again, this exactly the same 4 steps, everything is same except for this variable. I have chosen this question, the one with t. So what do we have to do? Step one, if you remember, y equals to, let y is equal to the given function. If you remember, hum aise hi karte the. Okay, now what do we have to do? We have to replace y with y plus delta y, and we have to replace t. Now this time we have t, so we will be replacing t with t plus delta t, yani change in t. Clear? Aur yahan pe kya hoga? Change in y. So what do we have to do is replacing y with y plus delta y, and we will be replacing t with t plus delta t, right? Do not make this mistake. I mean, you have to put a bracket sign over here. Yay. Why? Because now when I'll be opening the bracket, 3 will be multiplied with both the terms. It would become 3t plus 3 delta t plus 2 whole raised to the power minus 2. And this would be again y plus delta y. I hope there is no confusion still, right? Okay, now what? Now what do we have to do? What is my question? What is my y? This thing, right? This is my y, meaning 3t plus 2. What do we have here? Here, 3t plus 3 delta t plus 2. What? So, hum kya karenge? What do we have to do? We will be rearranging it, right? Are you getting it? How am I gonna rearrange it? Okay, let me erase this whole thing. It would be taking time. I'm going to erase it whole. Okay, look at this. I got this 3t plus 3 delta t plus 2 whole raised to the power minus 2. Now, how am I going to rearrange it? It would be like this. 3t plus 2 plus 3 delta t whole raised to the power minus 2 and y plus delta y. In all the questions, what do you have to do? Aap apne question ko dekhenge, question ki statement ko, jo wo hai, you have to rearrange the thing into that form. Ab ye mere paas, you can see, what do I have over here? 3t plus 2. Ikattha ho gaya 3t plus 2, right? Whole raised to the power minus 2. Yahan tak karke, you are done with your step 1. Clear? You, if you remember, step 2 mein hum kya karte the? We have to bring up this y to this side. Is side pe lekar aayenge, and it would be subtracted from the given term, right? Kaise? Let us go to the next page. Like this. Like this, right? Kya kiya? We did nothing. We just brought this value from this side to this side, and we replaced this thing like it was y before. It was earlier, it was like this. Delta t whole raised to the power minus 2 minus y. So you have to replace y with its value from the question, right? It is the same. Abhi tak koi difference nahi hai. Okay, now what do you have to do? You have to take this thing common. Hame yahan pe 1 banana hai, because this could be solved only by applying binomial. Uske alawa this cannot be solved. So I have to take this thing common. Mujhe yahan pe 1 chahiye. So agar mujhe 1 chahiye, what am I going to do? Delta y equals to, okay, look at this. I'm going to take it as common. It would become 3t plus 2 whole raised to the power minus 2. And what is inside the bracket now? This thing would become 1 plus 3 into delta t whole divided by 3t plus 2. I have discussed this thing in very detail in the previous video. So I hope no one is confused. This term and this term, they both have it. So we are going to take it as common. 1 plus 3 delta t divided by 3t plus 2 whole raised to the power minus 2 minus 1. Right? Ab hum agle step mein, very simple. What do we have to do? We will be applying binomial on this whole thing. Right? This being our 1. This being our n, and this whole thing being our x. This pure pe you will be applying binomial. Then this 1 and 1 minus 1 will be cancelled out. And rest of the thing, I think if you remember from the previous lecture, if you have done your assignments well, so definitely it's not a big deal at all. Change kahan pe aega, I'll be letting you know. Let us go to the next step. Okay, next step was, if you remember, we had to take out delta x as common. Right, and then we had to that was supposed to be done in the second part. Sorry, second step. Delta x hum common lete the, right?
what are we going to do with this question? Like, we were supposed to apply limit delta x approaches to 0 and we were supposed to divide it by delta x. But what about this question? We will not be dividing both sides by delta x here. We will be dividing both sides by delta t here, right? And we will be applying limit delta t approaches to 0. Why? Because the question is this. The question is this, y equals to 3t plus 2 whole raised to the power minus 2. What does it mean? The function being used, the independent variable being used is t. So we will be finding change in y with respect to change in t. So change in y ka matlab hai dy, right? And change in t means dt. And dy and dt kaise bante hain ye dy over dt? They become, if we will be taking it as this. क्या लिखा मैंने, लेट मी राइट इट अगेन. लिमिट डेल्टा टी अप्रोचेस टू जीरो डेल्टा वाई डिवाइडेड बाय डेल्टा टी वुड बी इक्वल टू, यू कैन सी नाउ, चेंज इन वाई विद रिस्पेक्ट टू चेंज इन टी, वेयर डेल्टा टी अप्रोचेस टू जीरो. सो इट वुड बिकम डी वाई ओवर डी टी, राइट? सो बस आपने वेरिएबल, इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल को देखना है एंड यू हैव टू डू द क्वेश्चन अकॉर्डिंगली, राइट? What do I mean by this? Look at this. You will be dividing the term by delta t instead of delta x. Kisse divide karenge? Delta t se. And then you will be applying limit delta t approaches to 0. And the place where you will be finding delta t, you will be replacing that with 0. Because you are applying the limit delta t approaches to 0, right? Look at the questions over here. I have chosen these two questions. One with x and the other with z. Let us discuss the question with z first. Independent variable here is z. Okay, I'm going to zoom it in so that you can see it well. Okay, now look at this. What did you do? You took this function as y. Right? You said, okay, let y equals to this. Now, you all are familiar from the previous lecture that you have to take it to the numerator where this plus 7 would become minus 7. Ab kya karna hai simply? You will be replacing this y with y plus delta y, and here the variable which is used as z, so this would be replaced with z plus delta z, right? A into z plus delta z minus b whole raised to the power minus 7. Okay, now open the bracket as we did in the previous part. A z plus a delta z minus b whole raised to the power minus 7. Now if you remember, I told you, what do we have to do? We have to rearrange this thing. Ab kaise rearrange karna hai? We have to form this question thing from this one, right? How do we do that? We will be rearranging it. So az minus b ko ek saath likh lenge, like this, az minus b plus this term a delta z. So a delta z, can you see this? Whole raised to the power minus 7. Clear? Achha, what do you have to do after that? As this is y plus delta y, right? Now yes, you can see they have skipped. Okay, there is a change of the step by them. This is your own choice. No need to do it this way. This is your own choice. Keep delta y over here. Take y to the other side. Then after that, take common. That is your own choice, right? What have they done? They took common from here, right? They did not take y to the other side. Before that, they took this term common from this whole. Kaise common liya? We all are already familiar with this, right? Kaise common liya? Look at this. This az minus b, this thing, they took this thing as common. So it would become az minus b whole raised to the power minus 7, like this. Here they would get 1 plus a delta z divided by az minus b whole raised to the power minus 7. Bilkul wahi, kuch bhi nahi kiya, exactly same question hi hai, just they, you know, change the procedure of the question. You can do it the same as you did in the previous lecture, right? Okay, delta y equals to, you have to take y to the other side. Up y ko is side pe lekar aaye, it became this thing, minus this thing, right? Bilkul wahi same. What do you have to do? You have to take this and this as common. So you took it as common. What do you have over here? Instead of this whole term, like you got, you have to do it this way. Okay, this az minus b whole raised to the power minus 7, and then this whole term would be there, 1 plus a delta z divided by az minus b whole raised to the power minus 7. And this, instead of this term, you will be having minus 1 because you took it as common, this term, right? They didn't write it here, you have to. Okay, rest of the thing is exactly the same. What have they done over here? Kya kiya inhone? They have applied binomial on this. Kaise? 1 plus, this is your n. So n into this whole is your x. N x plus n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial into this whole thing is being x. So x square plus so on into minus 1. Minus 1 plus 1 cancelled out. Now what is the common which you can see? A delta z, az minus b, az minus b. So you can take this term completely as common. A delta z divided by az minus b. This one is already cancelled out. What do you have over here for this term? What do we have? I have taken this thing as common. So what is left? Minus 7 only. Minus 7 yahan pe aa gaya. From this whole term, what is left for us? Minus 7, minus 1 divided by 2 factorial bhi reh gaya. This was whole square of this whole thing. Humne iska ek part, we have taken it outside. Ek reh gaya a delta z divided by a z minus b. Toh yahan pe likhya, plus so on. And we already know that when we would apply limit delta z approaches to 0, this whole term would become 0. Right? Now what do we have to do? Okay. Now what do we have to do? We will be applying, we will be dividing both sides by delta z. Can you see this change in z? So delta z and take limit delta z approaches to 0 on both sides. Achha, I was seeing the assignments of some students. They forget to write delta z approaches to 0 like this. Or delta x approaches to 0, whatever you may call it. This is compulsory, boys or girls. You have to write it down, okay? Ye bhoolna nahi hai. Agar ye bhoolenge, it would be considered as a mistake. So definitely marks deduction would be there. Okay, now look at this. Aapne apply ki delta z se divide kiya, delta z approaches to 0. It is the same still. Delta z se divide kiya. This and this cancelled out. Right? So rest of the question is exactly the same. Jahan pe aapko delta z nazar aayega, wahan pe aap 0 put kar denge, like here. So this whole term would become 0. And you will be getting what? This thing would be multiplied with this minus 7. So minus 7 into a into my az minus b whole raised to the power minus 8. How this became minus 8? Let me tell you this thing. This is az minus b whole raised to the power 1, you can say. And this is minus 7. When you are going to take this term to the numerator, it would become minus 1 like this. So minus 7 minus 1 whole raised to the power minus 8 ban gaya. And this minus 7 remained the same. This a remained the same, right? Now, what is the answer? Az minus b whole raised to the power minus 8 into minus 7a. Right? This would be your answer. That's it. So there is no difference as such, right? Almost the same. Just the difference of variable is there. So I don't think so. I should be discussing this question in the same detail. Let me just briefly guide you people. You are going to take this thing as y, this function. So y equals to this. This is exactly the same because the question is of x. So y plus delta y will be replaced with y plus delta y, and x will be replaced with x plus delta x, like this, right? Then you have to open up the bracket. Kaise? 2x plus 2, yeah, 2x plus 2 delta x, like this, plus 3 as it is, whole raised to the power 5. Ab humne kya karna hai? We have to make it as our question. As our question, right? So what is our question? 2x plus 3. So what am I going to do? I have to rearrange this thing. How am I going to rearrange it? 2x plus 3. Ek saath likh liya. Plus whatever the term left behind is, I'm going to write it down over here. So whole raised to the power 5. Kyun kiya? Kyunki this was my question. So that I can take it out as common later on. Right? Baki question is exactly the same. We'll be taking this y to the other side, you will be replacing it with the question, then you have to take it out as common, you have to apply binomial. So rest of the question is exactly same here. The independent variable is being x, so what do you have to do is you will be taking, again you will be dividing both sides with delta x, not delta z, not delta t, but delta x, because the independent variable you can see over here is used as x. Jo independent variable hoga usi ke hisab se change in y aap find karenge, right? And the question is exactly same, and this would be your answer for that, right? Okay, let us go to the next slide. let us talk about your assignments. And this is how you're going to do all these five questions. Let me show it to you once again. This, right? So all the questions are same, right? Exactly same by this method. Just a change of independent variable is there. Here the independent variable you can see is t. So you'll be dividing it by delta t. Delta y will be divided by delta t, and limit will be taken as delta t approaches to 0. Here the function will be divided by delta y will be divided by delta z, and the limit would be delta z approaches to 0. Rest of the questions are about x, so they would be the same. So let us talk about now assignments. Do the following questions neatly and with proper steps. You have to do these three questions within this time, like up till 9:30. I'm going to end up this video so that you can have the time for your assignment, right? And then you have to complete this on weekend. I know you are going to have a physics test on Monday, inshallah, but you'll be having 2 days, right? So you can do some random parts, but you have to send them to me during the weekend. Okay, girls and boys, wish you all the very best for your today's assessment. Allah Hafiz.